क्वेश्चन नंबर 26, एन इक्वी बाई कॉन्वेक्स लेंस ऑफ रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स 1.5 एट फोकल लेंथ 20 सेंटीमीटर इज कट इनटू टू पार्ट्स एंड प्लेस्ड इन कॉन्टैक्ट एज शोन इन फिगर. अ लिक्विड ऑफ रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स 1.3 इज फिल्ड बिटवीन द टू पार्ट्स ऑफ लेंस. द इक्विवेलेंट फोकल लेंथ ऑफ द कॉम्बिनेशन इज. सो इन द इनिशियल कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इक्वी बाई कॉन्वेक्स लेंस इफ आई कैलकुलेट द रेडियस ऑफ कर्वेचर देन 1 अपॉन एफ is equal to mu 2, that is 1.5 or 3 by 2 minus 1 divided by 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. So this comes out to be 2 by r. So from here, the radius of curvature of the equiconvex lens is equal to f, and this is equal to 20 centimeter. Now if I calculate the focal length of this first part, then I can say that 1 upon f1 is equal to mu 2, that is 3 by 2 minus 1 divided by 1, 1 upon r1. So the rays are coming from the infinity. So 1 upon infinity minus of minus r, minus 20. So on solving, it comes out to be 1 by 40. So whatever is the focal length of the first part, that is also the focal length of the third part. If I calculate the focal length of the second part, that is behaving like a concave lens. So 1 upon f2 is equal to mu 2, that is 1.3 minus mu 1 divided by 1 in air into 1 upon minus r minus of 1 by r. So minus 2 by r, and the value of r is 20. So on solving, it comes out to be minus 3 by 100. If I write the equivalent focal length of the combination 1 upon f equivalent, that is equal to 1 upon f1 plus 1 upon f2 plus 1 upon f3. Since f1 and f3 are same, so I can write this is equal to 2 times 1 by 40 minus 3 by 100. So on solving, it comes out to be 1 by 50. So the value of f equivalent comes out to be 50 centimeters. So option 2 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 27. In question number 27, two plane mirrors are inclined at an angle theta. If any ray incident on one mirror becomes anti-parallel after reflection from the other mirror, then angle theta can be. So it is a standard fact, if the ray becomes anti-parallel, then the angle between the two mirrors must be 90 degree. So option 4 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 28. In question number 28, if angle of minimum deviation of a prism is equal to the refracting angle of the prism, then refractive index mu of the material of the prism satisfies. So it is given that delta minimum is equal to A, that is the refracting angle of the prism. So mu is given by sine of A plus delta minimum by 2. So delta minimum is A, so A by 2 divided by sine A by 2. So if I solve this, this comes out to be 2 cos A by 2. So from here, cos A by 2 comes out to be mu by 2, and the value of cos A by 2 must be less than 1. So from here we get the value of mu must be less than 2. We also know that delta plus A is equal to I plus I dash. And the value of I plus I dash is always less than 180 degree. So I can say that delta plus A is less than 180 degree. And since in this case, the value of delta minimum and A are same, so 2A is less than 180 degree, A is less than 90 degree. So if A is less than 90 degree, then if I see this equation, when A decreases, the value of cos A by 2, when A decreases, the value of cos function will increase, or I can say that the value of mu is greater than 2 cos 45 degree. So mu is greater than 2 cos 45 degree, that is 1 by root 2. So mu is greater than root 2. So I can say that mu is less than 2 but greater than root. So option 3 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 29. In question number 29, in a vernier caliper, one main scale division is equal to 1 mm and 10 vernier scale division are equal to 9 main scale divisions. So from here we can say that the value of one vernier scale division is equal to 9 by 10 mm and value of one main scale division is equal to 1 mm. Further, what is given in the question? To find the zero error of the instrument when the jaws are kept together, it is found that the sixth vernier scale division coincides with the sixth main scale division. The zero error of the vernier caliper is. So in order to calculate the zero error of the vernier caliper, so zero error is equal to, it is given that the sixth vernier scale division coincides with the sixth main scale division. So the reading of the sixth main scale division is 6 into 1 mm minus sixth vernier scale division, and the value of one vernier scale division is 9 by 10 mm. So if I solve this, if I take 6 to be common, then it comes out to be 1 by 10 into mm. So it is equal to 0.6 mm. So option 3 is the correct answer. Let's move to question number 30. In question number 30, in a meter bridge experiment, the gaps are bridged by coils P and Q having a smaller resistance. A balance is obtained when the jockey key makes contact at a point of the bridge wire 40 cm from the P end. So from here we can see that suppose this is meter bridge combination and this is 1 meter wire. So this is P left and this is Q. So this is galvanometer and initially jockey is at this position. So this is at the distance 40. So we can say that P by Q is equal to 40 by 60, or the value of P is equal to 2 by 3 of Q. Now further, what is given in the question? On shunting the coil Q with a resistance of 50 ohm, the balance point is moved through 10 cm. The resistance P and Q respectively are. So if Q is shunted with the resistance of 50 ohm, then the effective resistance will decrease. So it will means that if I maintain the ratio, then this distance will also decrease. So it means it moves in this direction by a distance, then it would become 50 and this is also 50. So in that situation, this resistance and this equivalent resistance must be equal. So I can say that the value of P, that is 2 by 3 Q, must be equal to the equivalent resistance of these Q and 50. So that is 50 Q divided by 50 plus Q. So if I solve this, the value of Q comes out to be 25 ohm. And on substituting the value of Q in P, it comes out to be 50 by 3 ohm. So option 3 is the correct answer. So by this, I wish you all the best for your preparation. Have a good luck. Thank you.